GNOME is developing a free desktop for the next generation. It's created by an open community, which provides a simple and beautiful experience for everyone. The application core is continually being improved. Many of the advancements were made by new and longtime contributors alike, together with GNOME interns from Outreachy and Google Summer of Code. Files has seen a lot of new development this cycle. Archives are now automatically extracted when opened. Files can also compress your data to the most commonly used archive formats, such as ZIP, TAR, and 7-Zip. Moreover, bulk renaming support makes it possible to rename multiple files at once in a single operation. A variety of patterns can be used, such as numbers or file metadata. This makes organizing large collections of files easy and convenient. GNOME software has received visual improvements and Flatpak integration. The landing page has been polished to be more attractive and colorful. This cycle also lands further integration for installing Flatpak bundles and repositories. Furthermore, GNOME Photos can share images from your image collection. Currently, sharing is supported by email and via Google Photos. Calendar supports using drag and drop to move your calendar events, making event rescheduling a breeze. Polari includes support for remembering passwords when identifying with authentication services. And GNOME Games has received gamepad support. Major work is being undertaken to improve the desktop infrastructure. GNOME is enhancing desktop security by building sandboxing technology with GTK, Wayland, and Flatpak. With this release, developers can make use of sandboxing technology directly from GNOME Builder. From the revamped header bar, you can compile your projects against a Flatpak runtime. GNOME 3.22 will be available through many distributions soon. We hope you like it. The GNOME community is friendly and open for anyone. We invite you to help us push the free desktop further by getting involved today.